हेलो एवरीवन, आई एम मिसेस संध्या रविंद्र लंके, लेक्चरर श्री जैन विद्या प्रसारक मंडल, रसिकलाल एम धारीवाल, कॉलेज ऑफ फार्मेसी, चिंचवड, पुणे. टुडे विल डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक्स सॉलिड डोसेज फॉर्म मेंशन इन द सिलेबस ऑफ सेकेंड ईयर डिप्लोमा इन फार्मेसी स्टूडेंट्स फॉर फार्मास्यूटिक्स 2 सब्जेक्ट. डिस्कस द लर्निंग आउटकम्स ऑफ दिस प्रेजेंटेशन. After watching this presentation, you will be able to define powders, you will be able to discuss types of powder, and you will be able to list advantages and disadvantages of powders. Now, one by one, we'll discuss about the various points mentioned here. The introduction to powders. A pharmaceutical powder is a mixture of finely divided drug or chemicals in dry form. These are available in crystalline or amorphous form. These are solid dosage form of medicament which are meant for internal as well as external use. They are having particle size very small. The particle size plays an important role in physical, chemical and biological properties of the dosage form. There is a great relationship between particle size of powder and rate of dissolution, rate of absorption as well as therapeutic efficacy of the drug. The advantages of powders. Actually, powders are one of the oldest dosage form and are used both for internal as well as external administration. Powders, they are having fast dispersal of medicament as compared to tablets and capsules. The onset of action of powder drug is rapid as compared to other solid dosage form. The large quantity can be easily administered by patient easily. Then the powders are more easy to carry than the liquid dosage form. Economical as compared to other dosage form, as no large equipments are required for preparation of powders. Then they are convenient for children as well as elderly patients. In case of tablets and capsules, there are chances of swallowing problem in case of elderly patients as well as children, but it is not in the case of powders. Along with suitable vehicle, they can be easily administered. They are more stable than liquid dosage form. Then they are easy to carry than liquid dosage form. Convenient for dispensing the bulky drugs. Flexibility of compounding, and they are less incompatible as compared to liquid dosage form. So these are some advantages of powder. The next one are disadvantages of powders. Here we'll discuss all the points. The first one is drugs having bitter, nauseous, unpleasant taste cannot be administered or dispensed in the form of powders. The drugs affected by atmospheric conditions are not suitable for dispensing in powder form. Some deliquescent and hygroscopic drugs cannot be dispensed in powder form. The dispensing of powder is time consuming. So these are some disadvantages of powder. The next point, that is classification of powders. Powders are broadly classified into 5 different classes: bulk powder for internal use, bulk powder for external use, simple and compound powder, powder enclosed in cachets and capsules, and last one is compressed powders. One by one, we have to discuss all these classes in detail. The first one, powders for internal use. The bulk powder for internal use are preferred when accuracy of dosage form is not important. At that time, powders are dispensed in the form of bulk form. They are supplied in several doses. As name indicate, as they are dispensed as bulk powder, they contain several doses of drug. They are supplied in wide mouth containers, which will permit easy removal of a dose. The non-potent substances which are supplied in the bulk powder are the examples like laxative powder and antacid powder. The next one, bulk powders for external use. In this case, the bulk powder for external use, they are mainly the non-potent type of substances. These powders are supplied in cardboard, glass or plastic containers which are often designed for the specific method of application. Various examples of bulk powder for external use are the dusting powders, insufflations, snuffs and dentifrices. So again in detail we will discuss about all the four types. First one are the dusting powder. Here you can see the marketed preparation, Mycoderm powder. The dusting powders are external applied powders on the skin, and they are generally applied in very fine state to avoid the local irritation. These are mainly applied in very fine state of subdivision so as to avoid the local irritation. Hence, the dusting powders, they are passed through sieve number 80 or 120 so as to enhance their effectiveness. Dusting powders are of two types, medicated dusting powder and surgical dusting powder. These dusting powders, they are prepared by using some of the ingredients like starch, talc, kaolin, as these substances are chemically inert in nature. The dusting powders are dispensed in sifted top or aerosol type of container. Now let us the two types, medicated and surgical dusting powder. First of all, the medicated dusting powder, they are mainly used for superficial skin conditions, whereas surgical dusting powders are used in body cavities and also on major wound as a result of burns and umbilical cords of infants. Surgical dusting powder must be sterilized before their use, where medicated dusting powders must be free from pathogenic microorganism. The medicated dusting powder, they are mainly used for antiseptic, astringent, absorbent, antiperspirant and antipruritic effect, while surgical dusting powder are used as lubricant, protective, astringent and antiseptic. The surgical dusting powders are sterilized by using dry heat sterilization method at 160 degrees Celsius for 2 hours. Talc and kaolin are more commonly used because these are chemically inert in nature. Some ingredients are readily contaminated with pathogenic bacteria and these must be sterilized by dry heat method. So before use, it is heated at 160 degrees Celsius for 2 hours in an oven. The dusting powder, they are generally containing talc, starch as the major ingredient. Here you can see an example. Talc and starch are the main ingredients. Then zinc oxide can be used as astringent and salicylic acid is also used in the formulation of this particular. Next one is the insufflations. Insufflations, these are again the second type of bulk powder for external use. Now these insufflations, these are also one type of medicated dusting powders. They are introduced into body cavities such as nose, throat, ears, vagina with the help of an apparatus known as insufflator. Here you can see the image of insufflator. This insufflator sprays the powder into stream of finely divided particles all over the site of application. Insufflations produce a local effect in the treatment of ear, nose, throat infections with antibiotics. They can also be used for producing systemic effect from a drug that may get destroyed in the gut. Some difficulties are there which are mainly faced while using the insufflators, like there is difficult to obtain a major quantity of drug as a uniform dose, and sometimes it gets blocked when it is slightly wet or the powder uses wet. The insufflations should be finely divided powder so that a stream of fine particle of medicament will get applied to site of application. Nowadays, the insufflations are available in the form of pressure aerosols. These are used for administration of potent drugs, and that's why this method having advantage of excellent control of dose through metered valves. It also protect the product from external environment. So this is about insufflation. The next type of bulk powders for external use are snuffs. Have you ever seen this image? What is this? Yes. This one was used by our grandparents. Nothing but in local language it is called as tapkir. The marketed preparation of snuffs is nothing but chimney. So these snuffs, these are finely divided solid dosage form of medicament. These are inhaled into nostrils for antiseptic, bronchodilator and decongestion action. Snuffs are dispensed in flat metal boxes or glass container with hinge lid. So this is about snuffs. Are the simple and compound powder for internal use. As name indicate, the simple powders, they contain only one ingredient either in crystalline form or in amorphous form. While in case of compound powders, they contain two or more than two substances which are mixed together. One is examples of simple and compound powder. In case of simple powder, only one drug is there. So the direction can be given as dispense 6 powders of aspirin. Each powder contains 300 mg of aspirin. So here one powder with a direction, one powder to be taken after every 6 hours. So in this case, what we have to do? We have to powder the aspirin, weigh the required quantity of aspirin, weigh 300 mg of aspirin for each powder, wrap each dose in individual powder paper, then prepare such 6 powders and pack it flap to flap, and then we have to tie it with the band, and then we have to dispense it into the suitable container. Likewise for compound powder, example is APC powder. Dispense 8 powders of APC, where aspirin 300 mg, paracetamol 150 mg and caffeine 50 mg. So here also the direction is one powder to be taken when need arise. So in this case, what we have to do? We have to powder all ingredients and weigh the calculated quantity of each ingredient. Mix them in ascending order of their weight. Then weigh 500 mg of the mixed powder for each powder. Wrap each dose in individual powder paper. Pack it in paper flap to flap, and then we have to tie it with the elastic band. So this is about simple and compound powder for internal. The next one is powders enclosed in catches. Now, what are these catches? Have you imagined that rice flour can also be used as one of the covering for powders? Yes, that is nothing but catches. Here you can see in the diagram, whatever the capsule like shell is there, it is made up of rice flour, and that particular dosage form is known as catchets. So here we'll discuss about catchets. These are solid unit dosage form of drug These are molded from rice paper, which are used to enclose nauseous or disagreeable powders. These are made by pouring a mixture of rice flour and water between two hot polished revolving cylinders. The water evaporates and a sheet of water is formed. Catches are used to enclose the disagreeable powders. These are available in different size so as to hold the drug from 0.2 to 1.5 gram of powders. Catches, they are also known as wafer capsules. They are quite hard to swallow as such, but they are softened by dipping in water for few seconds and then place on the tongue and swallow with draught of water. After swallowing catches, that it gets disintegrate and then drug is released. Now, discuss about advantages of catchets. The catchets, they can made easily as no complicated machinery is required. The large dose of drug can be swallowed by using catchets because once they get softened by immersion in water, even large size catchets can be swallowed easily without any difficulty. The drug can be easily dispensed in the catchets. They disintegrate quickly in the stomach. Next one are the disadvantages of catchets. In this, the first one is they occupy more space than corresponding size of tablets and capsules. The shell of catchets are fragile, so the drug cannot be compressed in catchets. Then they can't protect the enclosed drug from light as well as moisture. They are not suitable for filling the drug by large scale machinery. They must be softened before swallowing. And they are easily get damaged. So this is about disadvantages of catchets. Is the types of catchets. Catchets are of two different types. The wet seal catchets and dry seal catchets. First of all, we'll discuss about wet seal catchets. These wet seal catchets, these are made up of two similar convex halves having flat edges. The weighed quantity of drug is placed in one half and the edge of the other half are moistened with water and placed exactly over the first top containing the drug. The flat edges of both the halves are pressed together in order to seal it perfectly. So this is regarding wet seal catchet. Then the second one is dry seal catchet. Dry seal catchet, it is also consist of two halves, the upper half and the lower half. The diameter of upper half is slightly larger than lower half, same as that of hard gelatin capsule shell. The powder drug is filled in lower half and upper half is fitted over it. The fitted filled catchets are then sealed in a machine by pressing the two halves. Then we have to remove and pack it in the boxes. Here in the diagram you can see here the wet seal catchets, which are consist of the upper half and the lower half. The drug is placed in between these two portions and then these flat edges or flanges are moistened and then they are placed over each other with slight pressure. We can press them together perfectly so as to have a perfect seal. While in case of dry seal catchet, here is the lower part and slight more diameter is nothing but the upper part. So the drug is filled in between this lower part and here is presence of the interlock system as that of in case of hard gelatin capsules. And likewise, just by applying slight pressure by pressing the two halves together, वी कैन सील द कैचेट प्रॉपरली. द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ कैचेट सॉरी द अनदर वन इज द कैचेट मशीन. हियर यू कैन सी द डिफरेंट स्टेप्स पुटिंग इन द कैचेट्स फिलिंग विथ पाउडर्स मॉइसन मॉइसन द लीड्स एंड देन पुशिंग आउट द फिनिश कैचेट्स. सो द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ कैचेट इज सोडियो अमाइनो सैलिसिलेट एंड सोडियो अमाइनो सैलिसिलेट विथ आइसोनियाजाइड. दिस टू प्रोडक्ट्स आर यूज इन BPC. दिस ड्रग्स हैव अनप्लीजेंट टेस्ट. द डेली डोज ऑफ दिस ड्रग इज अप टू 20 ग्राम विच इज नॉर्मली टेकन इन अ 1.5 ग्राम कैचेट. The next one is packaging of cachets. Cachets are packed in boxes or tins in which they are placed on their edges or lying flat. The container containing cachets should always be labeled with a direction for its use, that is, immerse in water for a few seconds and then swallow with a draught of water. Cachets are always stored in cool and dry place. Here you can see an example of marketed preparation of cachets, which is packed in a tin box. Next one is the molded tablets, also called by the name tablet triturates, or they are also called as compressed powder. Now here are the example of practically prepared tablet triturates. These tablet triturates are prepared by using molds. These molds are made up of stainless steel or plastic, also called as TT molds, tablet triturate molds. These molded tablets are flat, circular disc and usually contain a potent substance which is mixed with lactose, dextrose or some other suitable diluent. The powder molded to form a tablet is known as tablet triturate or molded tablets. Now, apparatus used for preparation of this tablet triturate is nothing but this TT mold. It is either made up of stainless steel or plastic. It consists of two halves. These are the two portions, two plates. Upper perforated plate, which is having an exactly the same number of holes as that of number of pegs in the lower plate. The lower plate also have two pegs here, the largest one, which ensure correct fitting of the plates. The molds are available in several sizes ranging from 30 to 250 milligram. Generally 50 to 250 tablet triturates are prepared at a time from a tablet triturate mold. Now here, very simple procedure is there for preparation of this tablet triturate. A solid medicament and diluents are finely powdered and converted into stiff mass with the help of volatile liquid like alcohol. The upper plate of apparatus is placed on clean tile and the paste is prepared into the holes with a spatula. While filling the holes of upper plate, every care has to be taken so that each hole will get filled completely and we have to remove the excess. This plate is placed over the lower plate. Then we have to apply slight pressure over the top plate, which will push down the plate in the downward direction and it will leave the mold tablet on the projected pegs. Then these tablets are spread in a single layer on clean surface and dry either in hot air oven or in the warm place. Nowadays, automatic triturate machines are available which can prepare 2500 tablet triturates per. Next is the packaging of tablet triturates. Tablet triturates, they are packed in airtight container to protect from moisture. It is better to pack it in a single row in a narrow tube sealed with plug-type closure and tablet trichurates are stored in cool and dry place. Here you can see the example of packing of tablet trichurate. So this is about solid dosage form. Till now we have discussed definition of powders, advantages and disadvantages of powders. Then we have list the classification of powders, and then later on discuss in detail about various classes of powders. So thank you very much for watching this video.